Did you know that the world uses a whopping 42 million tons of toilet paper every year? That's equivalent to cutting down over 270,000 trees daily for this one essential household. It takes complex technology to turn trees into toilet rolls. Wood processing, chemical engineering, and mechanical engineering all play a part in delivering rolls with the right size, texture, and properties. So how do they make toilet paper? Do not take this lightly, for the process is vast. But before that, make sure to smash that like and subscribe button. It starts with a machine called harvester, a powerful and rugged forestry machine utilized in cut-to-length logging operations for efficiently felling, delimbing, and bucking trees with precision and ease. And keep in mind the type of wood used for the production of toilet paper is bad wood, meaning the crooked trunks and branches. After the harvester is done with its job, the tree trunks are moved, ready to be turned into chips. As the raw material reaches the processing unit, it undergoes a series of steps to transform it into usable wood chips. The first step involves feeding the wood into a large machine called a wood chipper, which cuts the wood into uniform pieces. The uniform pieces are then fed into giant drums that strip off the outer covering of the wood. Once the wood is debarked, it undergoes a thorough cleaning process with a water bath to ensure its quality. To ensure the safety of the machinery, the cleaned wood goes under a metal detector to check if there is any metal on the tree logs. Giant rotatory knives cut down the logs into tiny wood chips. These travel down a conveyor belt into giant stockpiles. Before the next step, do you guys know why did the lumberjack break up with the giant wood chipper machine? Because it kept chipping away at their relationship. Did you know that the process of turning wood chips into toilet paper involves breaking the fine fibers down even further? This is done in large industrial tanks called decomposers, which cook the wood chips until they are converted into pulp. The cooking process can take up to 3 hours and involves evaporating most of the moisture in the wood, leaving behind chips that now contain only about 25% moisture. It's a fascinating process that highlights the ingenuity of industrial technology. In the next step, another material comes in, recycled paper, and boy, it is hard to get. A machine called a sorter is used to separate recycled paper from unnecessary junk, like plastic, tin, cardboard, etc. This happens when, firstly, all the junk is sent to the sorter, and a sensor detects all the unwanted garbage and separates it from what we need. A sorter can sort about 400 tons of recycled paper every day. Recycling paper is an intricate process that involves several stages. The first step is to collect the used paper, which is then sorted by type and quality. Next, it is put into a giant washing machine and passes through 14 stations until the fiber can be used again for new paper. Surprisingly, this hectic process is still more environmentally friendly than using wood for pulp. The washing machine breaks down the paper into pulp, which then passes through a sieve that separates tiny waste particles from pulp. After this, comes the fine cleaning process, where the pulp is thoroughly cleaned to remove any remaining impurities. Finally, the pulp particles are de-inked by washing them with soap. This makes the color particles in the ink attach themselves to the foam, which is then skimmed off. The resulting pulp has a sludge-like appearance and is then bleached to give it the typical white color of toilet paper. Once all these processes are done, the real papermaking begins. The papermaking machine is a massive piece of equipment measuring 120 meters in length. It produces solid paper from pulp in 4 steps. The first step involves placing the pulp on a large belt called a four-denier wire. As the pulp mixture moves along the wire, water drains, leaving behind a layer of intertwined fibers on top. The water removal process is facilitated by vacuum boxes and other drainage elements that help control the consistency of the pulp and the thickness of the paper. The wet paper sheet is then passed through a series of press rolls, which further remove any remaining water. The paper is wrapped around a Yankee dryer, where the paper is crepped. It gives a wrinkled look to the paper but also makes it soft. Well, how does this paper turn into the toilet paper we use every day? It is done inside a machine that produces 500,000 rolls per day. Papers are introduced on the machine, and different patterns, depending on the company they're being made for, are printed on the paper. Micro-embossing is done next, giving the toilet paper its signature dotting texture and softness. Then these papers are rolled on cardboard rolls and are shipped to the companies who ordered them. Amidst all these, the chemicals, temperatures, processes, and machinery used are highly inspected to ensure the safety and quality of the product. If you haven't subscribed to our channel and liked this video, then quickly scroll down and do it.